Good evening. Before we move on to the big debate tonight here on Last Word, there was an important bit of news that we thought we should address. Now, this report emerged in Times of India earlier today, and the report said that in a stern warning to Twitter and its executives, the government seems to be suggesting that they must remove objectionable and inflammatory content from the platform or else face the dire consequences, which could be even a jail term apart from other penalties. In case of failure, the company's top executive may face action under Section 69A of the IT Act. Now, this report quoted government officials. Later in the evening, after this TOI story came out, the Ministry of Electronic and Information Technology issued a statement saying that the report was exaggerated and that the government does have powers to take actions against objectionable content under the current law. So effectively, what the government did was cite the existing law to say that if there is objectionable content that could be a threat to the national security or even public order in our country, then the government has all the leeways and tools in its hand to actually act against that institution. We have to keep in mind, this comes at a time where the government has been in conversation with the top Twitter officials, where even the parliamentary panel has summoned the Twitter officials and held meetings with them. This also comes at a time when even the CBI is investigating Facebook and Cambridge Analytica for their alleged role in influencing citizens. So what is it that the government is trying to say as a message? Pankaj Doval, the senior editor for Times of India Digital, who wrote that story, is joining me on the phone line. Pankaj, can you just explain to us what it is that your story said and what did you learn from your sources?
Tanvi, the government, as you would have seen over the past few months, has been taking steps, you know, in order, trying to put in some kind of a regulation in the online space. Online is increasingly becoming very, very critical as far as, you know, shaping public opinion is concerned and other, even in other areas. And we've seen that the government had taken steps once the Facebook and Cambridge Analytica issue had come to the fore. And after that, the government has also been trying to, you know, had also taken steps against WhatsApp and was asking them to, you know, give an answer on the traceability issue. So the government has been taking steps to bring in some kind of a regulatory scenario over there. While from one aspect, you know, this is happening across the world, especially after what we saw in the U.S. and, you know, how the U.S. elections were supposed to be influenced by the social media. But then from the other aspect, if we see, most of these things are happening very close to the Indian elections. And obviously, it raises the doubt that why is this action being taken right now? What is the reason for that?
Yes, absolutely. Is there, you know, to your mind, a sense within the government that perhaps they need to set a few examples to get the message across to these social media giants to ensure that, you know, maybe they fall in line as per the Indian regulations? Because the issue is so large, social media regulation at times of elections, its possible use and abuse is such a big issue that even Election Commission right now is still, you know, treading very carefully here.
Yeah, obviously, this is a very critical issue and there has to be some kind of a, you know, regulatory scenario, even if not regulatory scenario, there has to be ways and means by which there should be some controls over the social media. Because while, you know, there should not be any kind of a control over what people, how people express themselves on the social media. But yes, if there is content which, you know, goes against, you know, the prescribed norms, then there should be some ways by which it can be addressed. Now, the only issue that normally happens is that, you know, the government wants immediate actions at certain points in time and the companies are slow to react because, you know, they have their headquarters to go back to in the US or wherever they are based out of. And so there is a big lag, which the government sometimes feel, does not serve the purpose. So that is the reason that the government has been trying to act a little, you know, I would say over-aggressive on these issues. And sometimes there is a rift because of this.
Yes. Well, when the government statement and the ministry statement came out in the evening, would you say in some sense, Pankaj, it also confirms your story? Because while it says that it may be a little exaggerated, the statement does go on to quote the exact law and say that the government does have powers, to act against these social media giants under the IT Act Section 69A.
No, Tanvi, actually the thing is that the statement in the evening was nothing but to just allay the fears of Twitter, that the action was not only against them, but this is a routine exercise that is happening against all the companies. And so what we had written was absolutely correct. The government has told Twitter and has also told companies like Facebook and Google that they need to be mindful of the content that is being carried on their platforms, that they need to react fast in case the government points out to certain anomalies. Now, you have to understand that apart from this kind of a issue, there is another issue which is happening in this field, that, Twitter has been accused in certain sections of carrying a right-wing bias, that they are against the right-wing and they have removed the accounts of that. So some of the things have to be seen in that perspective as well, that why is the government going a little over-aggressive when it comes to Twitter? In between, the Parliamentary Standing Committee had also called the Twitter founder, Jack Dorsey, to come and, answer questions. But Dorsey could not be there. And that had also created quite a big furore in the, as far as the government was concerned. So, there have been this kind of a movement in the recent past. And, some of it can also be linked to, Twitter's behavior against the right wing, trolls and, things like that.
Yes, absolutely. Pankaj Doval, thank you for joining us and really sharing your story as well as, putting it in perspective. Because while, yes, there should definitely be a system in place where the government keeps a check on the abuse of these social media the giants, but the fact of the matter is it shouldn't go overboard just because there is pressure from one side or a few organizations itself. Thank you so much for joining us and bringing us this story.